All right, so let's continue with quantum mechanics 101. And what I'm gonna do is talk about what I do in my lab, which is a technique called laser cooling and trapping. And the big idea follows from what we did in quantum 101, that last slide, and it's the following, is that I wanna take an atom, and an atom, it normally looks like a particle. And we want it to behave like a wave. So to get it to behave like a wave, its wavelength, its de Broglie wavelength equals h over p, like we said last time. And that's h over mv, and v is the velocity. So what we have to do is we have to realize that if we have an atom, what is related to velocity? And it turns out the temperature is related to velocity. It turns out that the temperature is proportional to the velocity squared. So what that means is that when it's hot outside, atoms are jiggling around like crazy, and then when it's colder outside, the atoms are jiggling less crazy. So velocity is proportional to the square root of temperature. If we now come over here, what we find out is that the de Broglie wavelength, let's just say instead of equals, is proportional to 1/√ of temperature. What that means is if I can lower the temperature, get the temperature smaller, it makes the denominator smaller, but in making the denominator smaller, I've made my wavelength bigger, and so I've gotten the wavelength of the atom to be much bigger, and I can get the wavelength of the atom to be on the scale of something I can measure in the lab. So the trick in the lab is, how do you get low temperature? Here's what I do, is here I use rubidium atoms, and the rubidium atoms are jiggling around at room temperature with a certain velocity. And then what I do is I use lasers. So I have a laser come in this way. That's the symbol for a laser. And that's a symbol for a laser, a symbol for a laser, this way. And then two others this way. And usually these lasers, I put them on sharks. I put the lasers on sharks. So that's a little reference to anybody that watches some movies with lasers on sharks, or lasers on cats if you watch Saturday Night Live. But what happens is, if I'm a rubidium atom and I'm jiggling around and I'm going this way, that's my temperature. So at room temperature, I'm jiggling all around. And let's say that I'm jiggling this way and I run into this photon. I'm jiggling this way, I get hit by the photon, and then what I do is I slow down in this direction. All right, and if I happen to be jiggling this way, I hit the photon in this direction, and what I have six laser beams in all six directions, and what happens is they absorb the photons, they stop the jiggling. Stopping the jiggling means that their velocity becomes smaller. A smaller velocity means their temperature goes down. A smaller temperature means the de Broglie wavelength goes down. And what we end up happening is instead of the atoms behaving like particles, the atoms instead behave like waves. So we're looking at the quantum mechanics of atoms behaving like waves by lowering the temperature, laser cooling and trapping. And by the way, that was 1997 Nobel Prize.